And good afternoon, YouTube. Doing another video from the trail up here. The blue dot there, I'm just off the canyon trail, and this is beside this large tectonic block you can see running from the northwest to the southeast there. Actually, I came up here the last 2 weeks. Last weekend, I came up this very spot. I went down to the southeast end of the block there, and then I was going to come back up, and I wanted to check out this gully here just above the blue slider there in the lower center, and I was going to check that out on the way back, but I ended up going down the side of the block to the southeast there and came back up the trail. Figured I'd come back this week and just head over there to that little gully. I just want to see what it looks like. But anyway, let me show you where we're at on the camera, and we're going to head up the hill here and then over the little saddle and down the other side and check out that little gully there. Okay, yeah, I just came up from the canyon trail down there up to this little saddle. So 2 weeks ago, I came down partway down this ridge here, and starting at the top and coming down, I noticed there was a lot of rock. Fairly good sized boulders on the surface, and you can see this whole hillside here is all big rocks. You know, they're not huge boulders, but fairly good sized rocks up here, and they're all down this hillside and all the way up on top. There's this little kind of a trough here in the middle. Yeah, you can see even up here there's a lot of boulders on the surface. So those boulders look like they've been here a really long time. They're buried halfway in the soil. They're heavily covered with moss. I mean, look at those. You know, you can hardly see the rock for the moss on there. And like, these are completely buried. And even this hillside down here down to the canyon trail has boulders from just around the corner up there and down here to just about where this little stream canyon comes down. And I'm thinking those boulders probably came down shortly after this block broke free. As you can imagine, before the block was free, you had the North American plate up here, and this was part of it, and it was up there attached to the side of the canyon, and at some point the fault came through there and broke, and there was a fault scarp where that block then slid down, and then this would have been a bench below a vertical fault scarp. And I imagine shortly after that period of time, as there was erosion taking place, broken up rock from that fault scarp would fall down on this bench, and then over thousands of years this bench gradually moved down here. You had erosion on this side, because that's where the fault is now, down where the trail is. So you had this slope eroding, this slope eroding, and it left this ridge here. But all of this rock probably came down from up there shortly after this block broke free, because you couldn't have this rock getting up here now, because if it broke free up there, it's going to have to roll down the hill at just the right speed through this low spot, roll all the way up here, and just have just enough momentum to stop here. And the likelihood of that this many times is, you know, not very probable. But yeah, let's go over here. Okay, yeah, came over the saddle there and down to this meadow. And I mean, I walked right by this last week. I think I walked right up there, but I was headed down this little grass strip to get to the next meadow. And here's this big gully right here. It's probably like a little bit of a spring. It looks very wet down here, so there's probably groundwater that percolates out here. There's not a lot of hill above here, there's just that ridge that's not terribly much higher than this, but maybe the way the layers in the rock are, maybe the water comes out here, because it looks like this is just a big soil bank here where it's basically getting washed out. I might try to get around this side. It looks like there's a flatter area down below and somewhat clear. This side gets really steep and really brushy. Yeah, look at this rock here. I wonder if that is got some serpentinite kind of stuff. Really colorful rock. Yeah, that's... Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of just gravel and dirt here. So yeah, this was probably the side of the canyon here when this block was still attached to the North American plate. So this is like one of the grassy meadows that you see farther up on the side of the canyon, like right around Goldmine Creek. There's this same soil type that only supports the grass. Yeah, let me see if I can get around down here, and maybe I can get down below and see if there's any sign of like a spring or something down in here. Okay, yeah, hopefully this camera is doing okay. It's pretty dark down in here. It's overcast and then it's down under the trees. But yeah, that's that little gully area in there. Looks kind of wet. Yeah, sort of a little bench down here below the... You've got the meadow, and then there's kind of a steep drop-off. You can see the grass comes right down to there. Yeah, I wonder if they came up here and did some logging too, because you see a lot of these multi-trunked trees like that. Yeah, I guess they probably could have, because yeah, the road, the old canyon road, used to go right up the creek there. Yeah, this would have been very accessible. I mean, they just cut the tree down, push it down the hill, and then pick it up at the creek and haul it. I guess they were hauling it up the road. Yeah, so I did come down a little farther. There is kind of a little gully running down here from that point. So yeah, maybe really wet years, there might be a little bit of water flow down here. Hope there's enough light for the video. It's pretty dark down here, and I think I've got to head out. So yeah, I did want to come down here and take a look. Yeah, I'm going to make my way back up here. I got to get out of here before sunset, which is coming pretty soon. So hope you enjoyed that look up here. And as always, thanks for watching.